One of our greatest challenges in understanding the risk of chemicals to both human health and ecological health is the uncertainty we have with how toxic a chemical is and the uncertainty we have with what exposure we actually experience. Assessing the risk of chemicals to human health and ecological health is still an uncertain process. In order to get a better understanding of chemical exposure at Superfund sites and elsewhere, one can collect samples of water sample, a sediment sample, a fish sample, and so on. But oftentimes, you don't find an organism that's even living at these areas. Or the organisms, if you find them, the amount of chemical that's in them becomes very difficult to interpret sometimes. What we're developing is something we call a passive sampling device. And this is a piece of plastic, to make it simple, but various types of polymers that act to mimic what would happen in a fish or an oyster, and eventually what would mimic the movement of chemical into the food chain to expose humans to that chemical as well. We use these tools at the beginning just to get an initial picture of what is there and how much. And then if it's a priority, going back in much more detail to determine exactly how much and where these are and how we might clean it up. And then once it is cleaned up, we go back in again to verify that the cleanup was successful. Our ultimate goal is to be able to develop a process for measuring long-term chronic exposure to hundreds of different chemicals in a very cost-effective way. The analyses at a commercial lab might be $1,000 per sample each time you analyze these. That cost can add up dramatically. If we can simply deploy something for a month and come back after a month and have a good measure of chronic exposure, we can literally reduce the cost and effort by factors of 10 or 100. Currently, a lot of the data that we're using to make these decisions are uncertain enough where many of us as scientists say we are not close to where we need to be to make certain decisions. And so this device is intended to greatly reduce the uncertainty in this risk assessment process so that decision makers can be more certain of the scientific basis that they're using to make their decisions.